work that we've been able to accomplish. Also pray for our oncoming council and oncoming mayor, that you would give them strength and knowledge and understanding as to which direction to lead this city. Pray that you would be with them from day to day as they make tasks and decisions. Pray that you would watch over this meeting and help us to do things in order and conclude our term and our venue here. In the precious name of Jesus, we ask. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Salute. Pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Tonight we're going to be doing a procedure that some of you might be familiar with if you've been with us on these meetings the first of the year. We will first call the roll to determine the quorum. Madam Clerk.
Ms. Robinson.
Present.
Ms. Olive.
Present.
Mr. Gordon.
Present.
Mr. Lenore?
Present.
Mr. Hamlin?
Here.
All present, Mayor.
Let the record show that all members are present and the quorum is present as well. We will first go into the, I call a meeting of the Bastrop Sales Tax District number one to order. This is the Sales Tax District has a board that is also the board of all the persons for the city of Bastrop, and we do this for the purpose of dealing with the budget of the sales tax district. The sales tax district is responsible for managing the half-cent sales tax, which was levied and is collected for street improvement and those related activities. There's a separate budget that is adopted and utilized during the year for this sales tax district. We have, I've called this meeting to order, and we have two items to deal with under the Bastrop Sales Tax District number one. The first, and we have a separate agenda sheet for that. The first is resolution number 09-BST-107-1278. A resolution amending 2008-2009 operating budget and street projects for revenue and expenditures for Bastrop Sales Tax District number one for the fiscal year beginning July 1, 2008 and ending June 30, 2009. This resolution is to rectify, balance, reconcile the budget that was adopted at the beginning of the year and was utilized during the year. There were projections made for revenue and projections made for expenditures. So now that the year is coming to an end, revenue and expenditures were probably different than we projected. So what we're doing now is amending the operating budget to make it right. So I need a motion, if you desire, to adopt this resolution number 09-BST-107-1278.
I make a motion, Mayor, that we adopt resolution number 09-BST-107-1278.
Mr. Lenore makes a motion.
I'll second.
Ms. Olive seconds Mr. Lenore's motion. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Is there any opposition? The ayes have it. The resolution is adopted. Now, the second item on the agenda is resolution number 09-BST-108-1280, a resolution adopting an operating budget and street projects for revenue and expenditures for the Bastrop Sales Tax District for the number one for the fiscal year beginning July 1, 2009 and ending June 30, 2010. Just as we amended last year's budget, this resolution is adopting an operating budget, a operating budget for 2009-2010 for the sales tax district, which is for the street improvement program. This consists of some street projects and purchases and operating that. So in order for the sales tax district to function and for the new administration to carry forth, a budget needs to be adopted, and this is what this resolution does. Is there a motion to adopt that resolution?
Mayor Hawkins.
Mr. Gordon.
I make a motion we adopt BST 108-1280.
Okay, Mr. Gordon makes a motion.
Second.
Mr. Hamlin seconds his motion. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
If you oppose, say no. Is there any opposition? There are hearing none. The motion passes. The resolution is adopted. Is there a motion to adjourn Bastrop Sales Tax District Number 1?
I make a motion to adjourn, Mayor.
Mr. Lenore makes a motion.
I'll second.
It's a second, and we are adjourned. Now we're going into our regular agenda, and thank you for that. We've called a roll. We've determined that there's a quorum, and just a few announcements. First, this is the last scheduled meeting of this mayor and board of alderpersons. Our four-year term expires on June 30th, and we will note this term will expire, and we will no longer serve in these capacities. This four-year term, I think, has been successful. We've had some significant events, some significant events, both mostly positive. We've had some negative and horrendous experiences during this time, but I think we've served well. We can leave on June 30th feeling that we have done the work that the people of the city of Bastrop sent us to do without any reservations or hesitations. I compliment members of this board of alderpersons, and I express my appreciation to you for an outstanding job. You have served well. The constituents of your district can be proud of what you've done during this four-year term. The city of Bastrop is, I think, better at the end of this term than it started. We've had some events that we had no control over. I'm not saying that the economy is better. I'm not saying that the labor employment situation is better. But as far as the soundness of our government, we are sound. We have passed all kinds of audit experiences. We've not had any negative, severe negative findings from the legislative auditor. We've not had any malfeasance in office. We've not had any criminal charges filed against us. So I am extremely pleased to have worked with you during this four-year term. I applaud you, I compliment you, and thank you for the work that you've done during this four-year period. We have, the staff and I, have been working diligently to create a smooth transition so that on June 30th, and when our term ends, and July 1st, when the new administration comes in, they will be able to pick up the ball and pass the baton will be passed, and that will be a smooth transition. We have many, many projects that are going on. Some of the projects can't be completed, but they are ongoing, and we just got a message last week that we're the recipients of $1.5 million, and I better be careful about that because I don't know if the last time I did something like this, legislator got mad with me. But we got some stimulus money, so I don't want to make a big announcement because Mike Walsworth and Sam Little might get angry with me for making preempting them. But we got some stimulus money on a major project that we sent paperwork in to Baton Rouge just today. We overnighted it so that it could be completed. Mr. Floyd is working on several million dollars worth of projects that are involving the police department for technology grants, and the city of Bastrop's police department and Chief Black are state of the art. They have capacity that you would not believe. Our street department and public works department is going and growing. Many of you don't know it, but we have two mosquito trucks going right now as we speak. We have added another unit, which is going to help us with our coverage and help diminish the proliferation of mosquitoes and insect infestation. We're abating standing water and encouraging folks to empty water out. And some of these things seem really insignificant, but they are things that go to make your quality of life much better. We're just doing all kinds of things. We have several projects. We're collaborating with Keep Morehouse Beautiful and beautifying some streets and other areas, and working with the economic development folks on the revitalization plan. Ms. Olive has been meeting with the folks who are doing the land use plan. The airport fencing project is up and running, and we're going to collaborating with Homeland Security and providing the security at the airport. working with the Sheriff's Department in transitioning the emergency response facility over to the Sheriff's Department. And just things are happening. This is the best time in the world of being the city of Bastrop. Somebody asked me, what's going to happen to Bastrop? You know, you had the economic situation with the mill closing and ConAgra. I said, Bastrop is going to grow and develop and flourish, and there'll be a new day in Bastrop. We have so much potential here that anybody within a sense would be foolish to ignore the capacity that we have. We're going through our Job time. If you about biblical scholars, you know that Job went through some turmoil. He suffered greatly, but he was restored and restored to a better position than he was originally. The economy is going to turn around. We have land capacity, we have people capacity, we have transportation capacity, and we're just rightly situated to grow. There's some things, though, that we must do as far as the retail and tax situation is concerned. I'm going to constantly preach, no matter where I am, the fact that Bastrop can support itself if we shop at home. If we shop at home, if we spend the sales tax, spend our sales dollars and collect that tax in the city of Bastrop and Morehouse Parish, we can support ourselves. And that means that there'll have to be effort on two groups' parts. There'll be efforts on the part of the citizenry, the buyers, to select and choose to buy in Bastrop. The second part is that the people who sell and who supply are going to have to be friendlier, more accommodating, more providing of the items that folks want. People who sell and supply services and goods are going to have to act like they want folks to come in and buy there. How many of you have gone into a store and the sales clerk has either been on the phone or they're talking to somebody else or they're busy doing something else and they ignore you for a while before they even turn around to shop there? And since you have choices, sometimes I say, I'm not going to do this. I'm out of here. We don't have to. We should not have to endure that. Those people who sell shouldn't have to endure folks who are disrespectful, who are hostile, and who are demanding. It's a two-sided street, and it can work. If we want to survive, we want to continue to survive and survive well, those are two elements that we have control over. Attracting business, you know, it's a business person's market right now. They can go anywhere they want to go. And, you know, it, no matter how beautiful we make our city, if they don't choose to be here, they're not coming. But we can control those things that we can control, which makes us attractive. Our fire department and police department are well trained, and they are improving under the leadership of the two chiefs there. I expect great things out of them. Our public works department, we're becoming technologically competent and equipment ready. We are improving in an efficient manner with the capacity that we have to serve better. Our administration, we just signed paperwork today to bring us more into the 21st century as being able to pay taxes online and enhancing other capacities that we have. So expect great things from the new administration and from the folks who work in the city of Bastrop. This government thing is a two-way street. You expect things from your government, from the folks that you elect, but they also expect support from you. You have to support them, the elected folks. Don't just vote for them every 4 years and then forget about them and criticize them. Keep coming to meetings, and I'm so pleased to see the number of you here who, tonight. Maybe it's for them to get us out of town so we can be gone.
Nice.
Goodbye-bye. Yeah. Nice. But we are so pleased to have you here. I see several members of the new board of all the persons in the room, and we wish you well. We wish you well, and I think I speak for this entire board. We pledge to you our continued support of your efforts. One of the things that Barbara, as you know, and maybe some people ask a question, when are you going away? I have not been selected for a position yet. You know, as I said during the campaign, I was asked if I wanted to be considered, and I am being considered, but no choice has been made. When I told Barbara I wanted to do this, and she said, well, you can do anything you want to, she said, but I ain't selling my house. So I'm not going anywhere. I'm not leaving Bastrop. The welfare and progress of this city is of utmost importance to me. I love this city, and I thank you for allowing me these 20 years of service. You have helped me to grow and develop, and my task here during this 20 years is to give back in return for what you've given me and my family during this period of time, and I appreciate that. Thank you for listening to me. Yes, sir.
May I piggyback on you at this point right quick?
Yes, sir.
Before you returned, before you got back this afternoon, and when we finished the building claim, the council commended you and your department heads and the city workers on how abreast you kept us and how legal your team kept us. And we appreciate that. And I just wanted to make that announcement in here. We
have
talked about it already.
I appreciate it.
Thank you.
And like I said in there, me and the rest of the staff were afraid to do anything other than that because we were scared of y'all. We didn't want to have to answer to y'all on council meeting night because we knew if we screwed up, we wouldn't have to come in here and be responsible. But, you know, you elect the mayor to implement what you do. This body makes policy. You make rules and regulations. You pass the budget. And once you pass the budget and give us allowances, then it's up to us to implement. And I don't take, and those of you who know me, I don't take credit individually. Because there's so much stuff that I don't know. And those of you who work with me, you know I call up on you all the time. So what do you think about this? Give me your input. I give all the credit to the men and women who work with me in the city of Bastrop. I know many of you at different times have different opinions about us, whether we're doing anything right and whether we're doing anything wrong. And those of you who work for the city of Bastrop know that I don't profess, I'm not really critical, but I think I have had standards that I think the city of Bastrop had established. And all of you at various times, and I have had conversations about raising the bar or coming up to another level, haven't we? And it's been in the sense of trying to do what the citizens who elected us expect. And that's what it's all about. So I give all the credit in the world and appreciation as well to the staff. Those folks from the chiefs and department heads to crossing guards and dog pound people and folks who you don't even know work for us because they are the ones who make it comfortable for you to sleep at night and keep the streets clear and the sewer flushing and, you know, the cemetery and the grass cut and dogs and possums and snakes and other things that you wouldn't think that we do, keep that going. But thank you very much. I appreciate that, Mr. Hamlin. Item number 5 on our agenda is to, let me do one thing. I want to take something out of order. Let's go to item number 22, resolution number 091284. This is a resolution making application to the Louisiana State Bond Commission for approval of the incurring of debt and issuance by the City of Bastrop, State of Louisiana, of not to exceed $1,500,000 revenue anticipation note series 2009 and providing for other matters in connection therewith. Bill Bowles, who is our bond attorney, is present with us. Every year, we do what we call a RAN, Revenue Anticipation Note. And that's what this item number 22 is. Bill, speak to that briefly for us.
John, thank you, Mayor, Council. I appreciate it. I'm Bill Bowles with the Bowles Law Firm in Monroe, and we are here asking you to consider the resolution, which is what has been done every year since the last many years that I can remember, and I've been doing this for you all. It's the exact same thing we do pretty much every year, and many local governments do this. I do this on behalf of quite a few, and it is simply a borrowing, a revenue anticipation note, the same amount, and what I hope and firmly believe will be even less interest that we paid last year because rates are at low interest rate. And there's a number of people who have inquired about being added to the bid list for your debt here. It's a short-term borrowing. You'll pay it back every year before March of the following year. And it just evens out as taxes get spent through the course of the year, things get kind of thin about August. And so this evens it out for the end of the year until taxes come in again. So it's a borrowing in anticipation of those tax revenues that come in. $1.5 million, it says not to exceed six, but I expect it to be hopefully less in the twos. And I'll be disappointed if I can't get that for you.
That interest rate?
2% interest rate.
Sure.
So hopefully the interest and the, considering the time that you have it outstanding, it's really negligible. So this is what we're asking you to do. I appreciate you taking our, and just for the record, I do buy gas when I come here. And
you shop Bastrop?
Too.
Thank you, sir.
So that's what I appreciate you allowing me to serve.
Thank you very much, Mr. Bowles. Mr. Bowles has been a part of the team, our collaborative with folks in our community and in surrounding areas to make us have the successes. He brings technical and financial expertise to us. He and Steve Nusaka, who's our financial advisor, who was unable to be here, they helped us enter these waters and has helped us be successful each year that we've been able to do this. Ladies and gentlemen, this is the resolution. We've been through this each of the 4 years that you've been here. Is there any discussion, or what is your pleasure on taking action on this?
Mr. Mayor, I make a motion that we adopt resolution 091284.
Mr. Hamlin makes a motion.
I second.
Ms. Robinson seconds his motion. Is there any discussion? If in favor, say aye.
Aye.
If you oppose, say no. Ayes have it. Resolutions adopted. Mr. Bowles, thank you very much for coming. We appreciate you.
Mr. Mayor, thank you.
Okay. All righty. Now, let's approve the minutes of the previous meetings, our May 14th meeting. Item number five. You had a chance to peruse and review these minutes. What's your pleasure?
Mayor Honkin, I looked over these minutes. They seem to be in order, so I make a motion that we approve the minutes from the previous meeting, May the 14th, 2009.
Mr. Lenore makes a motion.
I'll second Mr. Lenore's motion.
Mr. Gordon seconds the motion. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, you say no, and the ayes have it. Mr. Hamlin, item number six is Finance Committee report.
Mr. Mayor, I make a motion that we adopt resolution 091285, bills and claims for the month of May.
Is there a second to Mr. Hamlin's motion?
I second it, Mayor.
Mr. Lenore does. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
If you oppose, say no. The ayes have it. I want to compliment and commend the staff for their frugalness and conservativeness in spending money, because as Bill was alluding to, and as we all know, as we get close to the end of our fiscal year, our money really gets tight. And something else that many people don't know, our fiscal year and the calendar year, our tax year and our calendar year are two different sequences. Our tax year starts January 1st, and sales property tax is paid by December 31st. But our budget year starts July 1st and ends on June 30th. So that's why there's a gap in there, which also necessitates us having to do the RAN. But that's where we are. Okay.
Mayor Hawkins.
Ms. Robinson.
Our resolution is 091273, and the number on the agenda is 091285.
Okay.
It really is 1285. That was a typographical error.
Okay.
1285 is the correct number that Mr. Hamlin put on there.
Okay. Let the record show. Do we need to adopt the resolution itself? The number on the resolution, or what?
No, he said it right, 1285, but he said the correct number.
Well, when
probably
you go,
need to correct the agenda.
Okay.
Yeah, we'll break down that.
So the agenda should be 1283?
1285.
Okay, that's what my agenda says.
Mayor.
Ms.
If
Robinson.
You look at it, the cover sheet is bills and claims for the month of May rather than June. So did that make a difference?
You get a new. Did you get a new agenda?
It was
in May.
Okay, hold on. Right. Wait. One at a time. Okay.
It wasn't.
Okay,
for
we
May.
Got. Just a sec. Okay. First, I think we have two different issues, Ms. Robinson. First, your comment was that the packet item has 1283 on it.
1273.
1273, then.
That's right, but it's been corrected. It's 1285, like Mr. Hamlin put on there.
So excuse me, just a minute. So this cover sheet needs to be corrected?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's my question.
Yes.
That'll solve that.
It has been corrected.
We're going to put 1285 on the cover sheet, Ms. Robinson, just as you were, that's where you were going, okay? Okay, now, did you mention something about bills and claims?
No.
Okay.
Just the number.
Okay, on, okay, good. All righty. That was a hard one, wasn't it? Item number seven, Kay King, are you present?
Thank you, Mayor Hawkins, and thank you, City Council, for allowing me to come and give my report this month. I would like to just say that there's never been a time since I've had this job in the last 4 years that I feel more optimistic than I feel about this community right now. And I love every day when I get up and do this job, and I hope that it shows. And I talked with Dr. Vines, who is the economic development person for the City of Monroe this week, and he kind of shared with me the same thing, that it's an exciting time for Northeast Louisiana. We're getting a lot of attention, and I think that we're going to come out of this and be stronger, and I look for a good future for Northeast Louisiana and the City of Bastrop. After saying that, I'd like to give a little bit about our redevelopment plan, and as you said earlier about presenting a technology savvy community and technical access to data is probably one of the most important things to site location people and is a driving force when a community is considered for business. And in saying that, on our redevelopment plan this month, our focus has been on our website and Ed B. and his group, that they're working with me to incorporate some of the new data that they have into a polished website. I have things from 2002 that we've kind of not had a real major renovation on our website. We work on it because a website is never finished. We work on it, but we're going to come up with soon, hopefully by the end of the month, that we'll have a little more polished look, and we're going to start incorporating some of these labor studies and some of the things that the people in the community have participated in, and they'll be able to go to the website and see that. And I know that Ed B. has been sending emails, and they're looking at developing the list of target industries and the assets that we have available here for that company, the things, kind of a fresh set of eyes, the things that they think are important for us to market. And in saying that, International Paper is moving along a little bit faster than we expected, and the building at the industrial park, the old liquid packaging plant, is on the market now. It's been on the market for a couple of weeks, and we've already had some inquiries about that building. I feel like that building is a huge asset and has potential to draw another major employer to this community. And the state has it on their target, and we have it on our target, and I've actually had some, a couple of inquiries over the last couple of weeks about that building. So I know I'm still getting inquiries about all of the Mills assets, but as we've indicated from the beginning, these are the Mills assets, and they're going to come available as the mill sees fit, so as International Paper sees fit. But things are very positive in that respect. And another thing about assets that are in the community that I was told today by one of my contacts in Monroe, that the I-69, I-530 feasibility study, and to recap what that is, that's the spur that's coming down from I-69 from the Monticello area, that study is complete, and they're going to be sending that, and as we have speculated, that you know, some of their primary routes will come through Morehouse Parish, which is huge for the future of Morehouse Parish, so I'm anxious to get that study. I haven't seen it yet, but I'm excited to get that study because I think that kind of complements the assets that we have available here.
Did your sources tell you which option they might?
I have no idea yet.
I'm anxious too.
I'm going to let everybody know as soon as I get a copy of it.
Where can it be found? How is it obtained?
Ben Marshall was the person. He emailed me today and said that he had a copy of it. It was a rather large file, and that he was going to try to send it to me over the internet. So I don't know if it got caught somewhere, but I haven't received it yet. But I'm very anxious to see what that says.
They contracted with somebody to do that study, didn't they?
Yes, it's Carter Burgess out of I think the Little Rock office was handling that.
They should be making that available to the public.
Yes, it should. I'm gonna just try to get a copy of it. I'm really anticipating getting to look at it.
Just to brief people who might not be aware, I-69, as you know, is coming out of Indianapolis, coming south, coming across part of Mississippi, almost all of Arkansas, dipping down and taking in a corner of Louisiana over between Minden and Shreveport, and then going on down to Texas and into Mexico. There's supposed to be a major interchange somewhere south of Arkansas, and they're going to do a leg. Is it 530 coming south? Well, something is going to be coming south. And the discussion has been, and Bastrop is naturally placed to be in the path of the connector to Interstate 20, a connector from 69 to 20, which is another east-west corridor. There have been discussions as to whether to redo 425 as they're doing right now and make that the connector. And there are two other options of bringing the highway, well, is it two or one?
Two.
There's two options. One goes to the east
yeah.
and connects in at Ravel.
Right.
And then one goes to the west of the current 425.
Yeah.
Those were the two routes that I, as I understood.
Right, when they had the session. We were fighting hard for the option that either duplicates or parallels 425, 165 into Monroe, bringing it as close as possible to Bastrop. There are others who wanted to come east of us out probably on the east side of Marouge down through or to Oak Ridge or somewhere between there and Holly Ridge and intersect with Interstate 20, and their purpose is to get it toward that mega site. What's the name of that farm?
The Franklin Farm.
The Franklin Farm.
Site.
And, you know, my economics and my demographics and my economic development tells me that it makes more sense to take it by major population centers. And the objective is to get it into Monroe. And the more direct connection it has to Monroe, rather than putting it in the middle of nowhere, it makes more sense. So we're anxious to see the study and see which one is the option of choice that they present.
So hopefully by next month I'll have a good report on that. Either way, I mean, Morehouse Parish wins on
yeah,
this.
Yeah, it's coming through.
It's a big surprise. Morehouse Parish wins. And
yeah.
This is just kind of the first step of getting that, and once again just shows how bright the future is for
Absolutely.
Morehouse Parish.
We're strategically located.
Now, in getting back to having assets, one of, and not being able to control International Paper assets, we did have a grant available to us to just recap on that Rodney Alexander's office had contacted us, and we had a project that we've been working on for some time on the development of the 165 corridor toward Monroe. And so this month we had submitted a pre-application, and this month we were invited to submit a regular application, which is a good sign, and we got that submitted by the 15th. We've got a little bit of paperwork that we're cleaning up, and that we're going to be talking a little bit more about that, but that's still going along very positive. And I there's no guarantees on anything, but this is still looking very good, and it'll be some additional assets that we have to market in this area if it's successful.
That's the EDA piece?
Yes.
And on that and many other pieces, in order to be able to get money from the federal government and the state governments, that normally and usually has to be some local participation. And the city of Bastrop in Is that part of the agenda tonight? Don't we do something? Yeah, we adopt a resolution a little bit later on committing to participate up to $130,000 as part of that.
Yes.
Is that right?
And so we'll cover that a little bit later. I just
okay.
didn't want to skim completely over it on
okay.
this on this kind of summary. And then as I do believe that one of my primary functions in this job is identifying the assets in the community. And I can't overlook the assets of many of our retired people that are coming back into the community, people that have had rich lives in other places who are still in that 55, maybe 55 to 65-year-old range. And we have a lot of people coming back into the community. And one of the questions on our survey that we did at the area businesses when Younger and Associates with the redevelopment plan was interviewing people, we tried to get a number on how many people we think had relocated into the community. But in keeping with that idea, we have to recognize that people that have connections to Bastrop, have connections to Morehouse Parish, are probably our most likely prospects to come back into this community as retirees. And one of the big focuses in the state of Louisiana has been that we want to attract retirees, being retirement ready. Well, I think that we can't get any more retirement ready than staying connected to the people who have left this community. And because of some programs that are available now through the Older Worker Program, I will have some help in the office. And this lady will be assigned, and she'll be contacting people in the community. And we're going to collect data from high school reunions, family reunions, and we're going to target people that are living outside of the area that come back into the community. And we'll be doing a periodic mail out, possibly get some of our real estate people to maybe feature a house on this and a newsletter type thing or even a card to keep people connected into the community that have ties into this community and show them what great value the community has and show how many positive things are happening here. And so that's one of our, I would call it one of our softer side projects that we have ongoing in the Medco office right now. And I hope that we're successful at that. And I know, Mayor Hawkins, you've been very aware of how many people, we call them expatriates, are coming back into the community and what a valuable resource that is to the community.
Okay.
And that's about all I have for right now. Is there any questions from anyone?
We'll call you back in a few minutes.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. As we transition, this mayor and board of all the persons, and earlier this spring, we've had a transition in the police department. We appointed a new police chief, and I take this opportunity, though, to recognize a person who has served the city of Bastrop extremely well for many years. He was extremely important to us in the last year and a half because he served as our interim police chief after the retirement of Alan Freeman. And it was initially expected to be a short-term appointment because we thought that we were going to be able to give the civil service exam and have the top-scoring folks and select the chief. And by spring, I guess, of 08, we thought that we would be done with that. But because of other matters, we were not able to complete that process until this spring. I call upon Chief Jesse Walker to serve in that position, and he did an outstanding job, the police department was experiencing growth and decline and all that, but Chief Walker helped us weather that storm with great efficiency and dignity and professionalism. I ask this board of all the persons to stand and give Jesse Walker a round of applause as we adopt this resolution and thank him for what he's done. Thank you very much. I thank the citizens of Bastrop and this community and all those folks who passed through here during that time. Appreciate you for what you did during that time. And with that in mind, I ask the board of all the persons to adopt resolution number 091282, a resolution commending Jesse Walker upon retirement as assistant police chief of the city of Bastrop.
Okay. Need a motion, Mayor?
Need a motion to adopt.
Mayor Hawkins?
Yes.
I'll make a motion that we adopt resolution 091282.
I'll second.
That's a motion that was triply second. Now, y'all setting records. We do double seconds, but y'all doing a triple second tonight. And we really appreciate that. Chief Walker, thank you very much for what you've done, and we really appreciate you.
I appreciate
you. Thank you very much.
Mr. Mayor?
Yes, sir.
Everybody signed anything but me, but I still think we need to vote.
You didn't care about the vote.
I don't know if they're signing it because they're excited, or they signed it because they're trying to get rid of Jesse.
Okay.
But I have both of them in my hand, and Jesse, I haven't signed either one of them yet because I'm waiting on the vote. Man.
See if it passes. So we had a motion and a second. Is there any other discussion? If you're ready to vote, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed just say no. The ayes have. Mr. Hamlin, you can make a unanimous now then.
Okay, I go and sign it.
You got it. Well, we had 4 out of 5, so that wouldn't. Okay, thank you very much. Item number 9 is teen court sponsorship. Here you have a packet number, item packet number 9 in your big packets is a letter from teen court asking us to sponsor them. Help me remember, staff. What was our contribution last year?
$7,500.
We've historically been asked to split the cost of supporting the ASO $15,000, and we've done all kind of scenarios. Mr. Lenoir, one time we would do it, and then the police jury would do it the next year, and
right.
We alternated that, and then we start splitting it 50-50.
Right.
We do $7,500, and they do $7,500.
Right.
Mr. McKee has, and my staff, have really started better utilizing those folks from teen court. And I think Judge Lester has been giving us an abundance of folks recently, haven't they? Yeah. Well, between teen court and some other programs. But the teen court program, I think, is working. What is your pleasure as far as participating in the item is to decide whether or not we want to continue to participate to the level of $7,500 a year to teen court?
I make a motion that we continue the $7,500 a year for teen court.
Ms. Robinson does.
I second it, Mayor.
Mr. Lenoir seconds the motion. Any other discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
If you're opposed, say no. The ayes have it. Okay, we're going to skip item number 11, the appointing of planning and zoning commissioners. Ms. Olive asked that we defer that, and that will be tabled until the new administration. Item number 12.
Mayor.
I'm sorry?
You skipped number
10.
Did
I?
10. Mm-hmm. Number 10.
Oh.
Said 11.
Maybe we don't want to appoint the enterprise. you woke up then, didn't you? You had your head down over there. I wanted to see if you were paying attention. Item number 10 on our agenda is to appoint the official journal. One of the requirements of the city of Bastrop and its administration is to appoint a journal. An official journal in which we report, list, and show our activities, provide our advertising to, and make public notice. This is our public journal, and we have to put our announcements in there about meetings and publish all of those documents that we're required to. We only have one local paper, and I think as I spoke to earlier, about buying local, I think we need to continue using our local paper to do that.
Right.
So if you would indulge me, I'd appreciate a motion to appoint the Bastrop Daily Enterprise as the official journal for the city of Bastrop, Louisiana.
So moved.
Mr. Hamlin does.
I'll second Mr. Hamlin's motion.
Mr. Gordon seconds the motion. Any other discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, should say no. The ayes have it. Thank you. Now I can go to 12?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Resolution number 091274, a resolution authorizing the city of Bastrop, Louisiana to increase their ad valorem millage rates for tax 2009, but not to exceed, not in excess of the prior year's maximum rates. Mr. John Hill, the assessor, is here with us tonight. Mr. Hill, would you come forth? We're pleased to have you with us. Thank you for the for what you do.
It's a pleasure to be here tonight. I just want to commend you and thank you for working with us over the past years, and looking forward to working with Ms. Alford too in the future.
Well, thank you, sir. Okay.
One thing I've noticed here in the agenda is that I think we need to reverse 12 and 13.
Okay.
You have to adopt the current millages first, and then, if you so wish to increase or roll forward to last year's maximum, then you would do that resolution second.
Okay. If you can give us a brief explanation as to what we're doing here. Adopting the current rate means?
Adopting the current millages would be the millages that were adopted last year.
Okay.
Under normal circumstances, this not being a reassessment year, you would just continue to adopt those millages and adopt the same one through that same period that, through the current reassessment period. So you'll do that first. And then if you decide to roll your millage forward, which you could have done last year, but you voted not to, you voted to roll back based off the increase in the reassessment period. But if for your second resolution, you can still do that this year.
Okay.
You can do that until the next reassessment period.
Okay.
And the reason for considering that this year is the fact that due to the mill situation, there may have to be an early reassessment period, and as soon as that happens, then you lose this. You're not able to roll forward.
Okay. I think it's important to realize that I think our millage rate is 40.47 or something like that, and we're not increasing the millage. But in the past, what has happened is the city of Bastrop has said, we collected X amount of dollars last year. And even though 40.47 mills will bring us more than that, is that kind of right? We want to stay where we are so we don't roll forward. We stay.
Right. Last year, instead of the 40 point whatever, you roll back to 39
yeah.
point something.
But legally, we were allowed to do 40.47.
You could have done that
right.
last year,
right.
yes, sir.
So this resolution 13 is adjusting the millage rate for last year? Is that kind
of? Both of them together operate to do that, but Mr. Hill is saying you got to do number 13 first.
I understand.
Yes.
Because I think there's a statute that speaks to the sequence.
Right.
Okay.
You have to create two resolutions if you're going to roll forward.
Okay.
And so the first resolution has to adopt the adjusted millages for reassessment, which is the same, which were the millages you adopted last year.
Okay.
So
well,
you'll adopt them first and
okay.
then adopt the
okay.
roll forward millages.
Let's do what Mr. Hill said.
Okay.
Now, item number 13, resolution 091275.
So moved.
Mr. Hamlin.
Seconded.
Mr. Gordon, all in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed should say no. Thank you. All right, now, 091274.
I make that motion, Mayor.
Okay. Mr. Hamlin makes the motion.
I'll second.
Ms. Oliver seconds the motion. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed say no. Ayes have it. No?
No.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Robinson?
No.
Ms. Olive?
Yes.
Mr. Gordon?
Yes.
Mr. Lenore?
Yes.
Mr. Hamlin?
Yes.
Mayor, it passes 4-1.
Okay. The motion passes. Mr. Hill? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate the information that you gave us as we prepared our budget. It helped us in making projections on revenue, and as we hope that it will be a good budget.
Okay. Well,
thank you for what you do, sir.
Sure, thank you. We're here to help anytime.
Yes, sir. Thank you very much. All righty. Item number 14. Resolution number 091276, a resolution authorizing the mayor to execute an agreement with the state of Louisiana Department of Economic Development to participate in the development and construction of an industrial development park in the region situated in Morehouse Parish. Ms. King?
This is in regard to our EDA grant application, that as many of you know, Kelsey Short had been assigned to work with the Bastrop community after the closure of the mill. In looking at the site, he felt that it was a good project, and he encouraged the state to participate in this. There is a 20% match. This will be a $2,160,000 total project.
Okay, let's do this. Last month, we committed to the match. Is that right?
Yes.
Okay. We took, if this looks familiar, members of the Board of Alderpersons, we took action last month, and we agreed to participate by contributing up to $130,000 to this project. Again, we're talking about developing an industrial park on 165 South, closer to Monroe, in an area which is more accessible to the highway and closer to Interstate 20. We're applying for an EDA, Economic Development Administration?
Agency.
And as I mentioned before, matches are required, participation is required. Kind of like putting up some money when you buy a house. And we've realized that in addition to agreeing to put the money up, we need to adopt a resolution.
That's correct.
And this is what this resolution is about. Authorizing the mayor to execute an agreement with the state of Louisiana saying that we're going to participate in it and go from there.
And the state is providing matching funds, and the $130,000 is actually not required by the state, but it's required by the EDA to finish out the match.
Is theirs like $350,000, something like that?
I'm sorry.
Is that where do I remember the $350,000 number coming from?
The $350,000 was committed to the match by the state.
Okay, that's what I was asking, right.
And then the $130,000 mm-hmm. will commit the city to mm-hmm. provide the balance of the match and possibly provide for any unreimbursable charges that we might have.
And the total amount of this is $2 million plus?
$2,160,000. I'm rounding a little bit, but $2,160,000.
So for an investment of 2.1, I mean, for to get to 2,130,000 is not bad. Now, we don't put the 130,000 in unless we get the 2 million.
That's correct.
Yeah, so we're not risking. Okay. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, what's your pleasure?
Make a motion.
Mr. Hamlin does.
I second.
Ms. Robinson seconds his motion. If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed should say no. The ayes have it. Thank you, Ms. King.
Thank you.
Resolution number 091277 is item 15, a resolution amending the 2008-2009 consolidated budget, general fund, and all special revenue funds for revenue and expenditures of the city of Bastrop, Louisiana for the fiscal year beginning 7/1/08 and ending 6/30/09. This is amending our existing budget to come in line with actual. This is making our budget a reality, the actuality. We projected last year expenditures and revenue. Revenue probably came in less than what we expected, so we have to amend the budget to make it, to true it up. So this resolution 091277 is amending the current budget that we're operating under today to make it true.
Mayor Hawkins.
Mr. Lenore.
I make a motion that we adopt resolution 091277.
Mr. Lenore makes the motion.
Second.
Mr. Hamlin seconds this motion. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, say no. The ayes have it. Item 16 is resolution number 091279, a resolution adopting a consolidated budget, general fund, and all special revenue funds for the city of Bastrop, Louisiana for the fiscal year beginning 7/1/09, ending 6/30/2010. This is the resolution adopting the budget for the next fiscal year. What's your pleasure?
I make a motion that we adopt resolution
09-1279.
Mr. Hamlin makes that motion.
I second.
Ms. Johnson, seconded by Ms. Robinson and Mr. Gordon. If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, just say no. The ayes have it.
I abstain, Mayor Hawkins, from this vote.
Let the record show that Ms. Olive abstained from voting on that item. Item number 17, resolution number 09-1281, a resolution granting a 2% longevity increase to all firefighters who have 3 years continuous service as of 7-109 and who have no more than 23 years of continuing service as of July 1-09 in accordance with state law for the fiscal year beginning July 1st, 2009 and ending 6/30/2010. The state of Louisiana requires that firefighters who fit this category, 3 years but less than, but not no more than 23 years, have to be given a 2% raise. Regrettably, because of our revenue situation, we have not been able to grant longevity, cost of living, annual raises to our employees. Our employees are living on the same money that they have been living on for many, many years, with the exception of fire people who fit that category. As part of the salary ordinance, we have to adopt an ordinance, because these are only folks who get raises. This resolution is establishing that fact. It's a statutorily required, as the law states, and we don't have a choice. I wish, I sincerely wish, that we had the capacity to give 2% and or more to our employees who are suffering from the increases in cost of living just as everybody else, but we simply are not able to do that. So this resolution would allow the 2% longevity increase to those firefighters who are in the category. Item number 17, we need a motion, please.
Mayor Hawkins.
Mr. Gordon.
I make a motion we adopt resolution 09-1281.
Mr. Gordon makes that motion.
I'll second.
Ms. Olive seconds that motion. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, should say no.
No.
Roll call, please.
Ms. Robinson.
Yes.
Ms. Olive.
Hesitantly.
Ms. Olive.
Yes.
Mr. Gordon.
Yes.
Mr. Lenore.
Yes.
Mr. Hamlin.
No.
Mayor, it passes 4-1.
Let the record show.
Mayor.
Ms. Robinson.
It's an after effect, but this came up in the earlier meeting discussing this, and that in lieu of the downturn in the economy, if there was some way that we might speak to the state government about this, because the police are not having the same privilege, that maybe we could do something about this. I don't know how y'all feel about it.
Okay.
I don't want them to not be able to make a living, but since it's been mandated by the state and things have changed so much, maybe we need to go back and have some discussions.
Okay.
I don't know how where you start.
But Mayor, I share with the council and finance meeting that article's in the paper in reference to what they're doing down there in Baton Rouge, and they don't like it, but they're not addressing it. Mm-hmm. Well, they're talking about it. So, and I tried to get this council to just vote against it.
Okay.
Not give them anything.
Okay. In answer to your question, this session is going to be ending on the 25th, and I think bills that they would consider for this session have already had to be introduced. And my recommendation is, this will be to the new administration or to citizens who felt strongly about it, that you would approach your legislative delegation before the next session starts and ask them to, if they felt strongly enough about it, to introduce legislation to rescind this mandate. But that will be the approach.
Thank you, Mayor.
You're welcome. Okay, item number 18, am I right?
Right.
Ordinance number 094190, an ordinance declaring certain movable property no longer needed for public use, authorizing the sale of each movable property at public auction, authorizing the employment of a licensed auctioneer, Buster Gay Associates for such auction sale and providing for the publication in accordance with the law. Every year, the only way that the city of Bastrop can dispose of property is by advertising and making it available to the public and having auctions. So we have vehicles and equipment that is surplus, that is no longer needed, and we have to have a public auction where anybody can come in and bid on it and they can acquire it. Everything from bicycles to computers to police cars and tractors and tanks and wire and all kinds of stuff. We do this annually in an effort to dispose of things. Are we collaborating with the Sheriff's Department on this? Okay. The Sheriff's Department is also contributing stuff that they no longer use, and it will be in that auction. Have you set a date yet?
Yes, sir. It's the 26th of June at 10 o'clock.
26th of June at 10 o'clock. Is it on a Saturday?
No, sir. It's on a Friday.
Friday. 26th of June at 10 o'clock at the garage?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So it'll be announced in the paper and all the rest of that. So if you adopt this ordinance, that will allow us to dispose of this property. That's ordinance number 094190.
I make a motion that we adopt this 094190.
Ms. Robinson makes the motion.
I'll second.
Jointly seconded by Mr. Gordon and Mr. Hamlin. Is there any discussion? If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, just say no, and the ayes have it. Item number 19 on the agenda. Is this our longest agenda?
I think so.
Jessica?
I think so.
You believe so? That's good then. And it's 10 minutes after 7. Okay, item number 19, permission to grant authority to the mayor to execute a contract with Denman Engineering for the American Recovery and Reinvestment Act of 2009 stimulus sewer package, $1.5 million. Now, please be gentle with us, because I don't want the legislators to think I'm scooping them on this, because they usually make those announcements. Please. This is a secret, y'all. But we applied for $1.5 million in stimulus money to do sewer work. I was in a meeting in Baton Rouge yesterday with my fellow mayors, and we are, as I can appreciate it, the only city in the state of Louisiana that got all the money that we asked for. The rest of my fellow mayors were complaining, and said, well, I asked for $3 million, I only got $600,000, and on, and I was just quiet as I could be. I wasn't saying nothing, I wasn't gonna tell it. But we were fortunate enough that we are awarded this $1.5 million, and there's much work that needs to be done in our sewer system, replacing ditch crossings and lines and other situations that are causing us problems. And this is reducing us using our funds, which we would use in other projects to do stuff. But this is one of those blessings that that come. So I need a motion to give the mayor the authority to execute this contract.
I'll make a motion in that order, Mayor.
Mr. Gordon does.
Second.
Mr. Hamlin seconds his motion. If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed should say no. The ayes have it. So when somebody asks you, what did Bastrop get out of the stimulus package, this is some of the money. There are other things that will be coming on a little bit later on, but this is what we're getting out of the stimulus package. Item number 20, permission to enter into a contract with Steve Pruitt for legislative services. Steve Pruitt is our consultant. We've engaged him, I believe, for the last 5 years. He came and met with Mayor-elect Olive and her team and presented information to them, and we are asking to renew his contract. And for the first time in 5 years, he's asking for an increase. We have been paying him $2,000 a month for this period of time, and he's asked for a $500 a month increase, and it is well deserved. Just ask people at the airport, ask Mr. Floyd, sewer department, because we have, I think Rodney Alexander said this in a meeting the other day, that he said, I think he said he saw me in his office more than he saw any other mayor in the state of Louisiana. And going to Washington pays off. it pays off. Rodney Alexander has been extremely helpful to us, as well as Mayor Landrieu, in helping us get money back into our community to help us do those things which we ordinarily would not be able to afford to do. So I need a motion to approve us renewing the contract with Steve Pruitt.
Make a motion.
Mr. Hamlin does.
I second.
Ms. Robinson seconds his motion. If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, just say no. Item number 21, resolution number 091283, a resolution formally requesting funding from Louisiana Department of Transportation and Development Division of Aviation to rehabilitate the fueling system at the Morehouse Memorial Airport. Is Brent here? Well, good. Thank you, sir. Brent Elton is our airport manager.
I guess everyone would like to know what this, what we're actually looking for in this grant. And what we're looking for is to install barricades around our fueling system to prevent any vehicles or aircraft from being able to crash into the fuel system and cause a spill. And also, we're looking to be able to get rid of some old, out-of-specification jet fuel that we have on hand and get our tank cleaned out, get all our associated plumbing cleaned so that we can get new fuel in that we can sell with some confidence to the flying public.
We have some issues in that the sale of jet fuel was extremely slow during a period of time, and the fuel that's in there is old.
Yes, sir.
And we have reservations about selling it to somebody because it might be contaminated, have water in it or something of that nature, and it might cause some problems. So part of this package is being able to clean, remove, clean, and rehab those tanks to some extent?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And then put protective barricades around?
Yes, sir.
Is this the traditional grant where they basically, between the state and FAA, it's 100%, or are they asking for 5%?
This is not. This is actually strictly from the Department of Transportation, the LADOT. It's a discretionary fund that they have access to that they're able to use with whatever projects that they see fit.
It's actually a gift.
No federal funding at all.
It's a gift?
Yes, sir. This is something that we are going to have to do, so either they can help us pay for it, or we can pay for it all ourselves.
Is there participation required on our part?
There is some required, and what we're offering to participate in is about $500 worth of installation materials and the labor for the installation of the security barricades.
Very good. What's the cost?
The total cost of the project is, I didn't have it in here. It's going to be right about $5,407.
Okay.
Very good. And we're asking the state for approximately $3,500 of that.
Okay. Okay. You've heard Mr. Elton and his presentation. What's your pleasure?
I have one question.
Yes, ma'am.
I assume this is old fuel. It's not good anymore. What has changed that we believe that we could sell the new fuel? I know nothing about airplanes or airports, so help me with this on my question.
As far as I understand it, the jet fuel system has been shut down. We have not been selling fuel out for probably since last October. And at that time, I don't think anyone really was able to judge whether or not that fuel was any good. It probably was within specification at that time, but the fuel system was shut down. It wasn't checked on a daily basis since then. And the Hiller Group, that is our fuel supplier, they really don't want us to sell that fuel. They don't want to have to stand behind it because of the possibility that something could be out of spec on it.
You check that mic.
I do know that we've missed out on several opportunities to fuel turbine aircraft since that system's been shut down. Okay. I don't think we need to keep a large volume of jet fuel on hand, but just enough that we believe we can sell in a reasonable time.
Okay. So you do have customers, though, for this fuel?
Yes, ma'am, we do.
Okay. That's what I was wondering, why it sat there so.
We're looking to change that as well.
Okay. Okay, thank you.
Okay, what's your pleasure?
Mayor Hawkins, I'll make a motion we adopt resolution 091283.
Mr. Gordon makes a motion.
I second.
Ms. Robinson seconds. If you're in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Those opposed, say no. The ayes have it. Thank you, Mr. Elton.
Thank you.
All right. Item number 22.
What did you do?
Oh, that's right.
We did that one, all right.
Okay, that's why I got that marked by there. Okay. Is there, we don't have any liquor licenses tonight? All right then. Is there a citizen who'd like to make a comment to the mayor and board of all the persons? Okay, if you'll come to the microphone, please introduce yourself and give us your address and we will listen to you. Thank you for coming, sir.
Yes, sir. Mayor Hoffles?
Yes, sir.
My name's Larry Robson. I'm representing Pelican State Youth Movement. And the reason I came up, I had a question. For the last 8 years, the city of Bastrop, and I'd like to commend you for supporting us over the last 8 years, have co-sponsored our monthly sport camp. And my question was, would the city of Bastrop still be able to support this on an annual basis?
Okay. Help me remember, what was our level of support? What did we do in the past?
Well, basically, you took care of the registration and you provided the gymnasium for us on the last day of the camps.
Dawson Park Gym. And taking care of registration, what does that mean?
Well, that's what the kids registered at.
We registered at the...
Is that city.
Okay, Ms. Tanzer, you want to come up and talk about that? Help me, help us with this. Mr. Allen Tanzer, Director of Parks and Recreation.
Okay, Mayor, what we would usually do, we would take all the monies for registration and everything.
Collect.
Turned in at the office at
Collect.
Parks and Recreation. Yes.
Okay. Okay, so we're not asking for money, but assistance.
That's correct.
Okay. When is this activity going to take place?
Usually it's always the last week of July each year.
Okay.
4-day camp.
Okay.
And I know with the economic crisis that we all going through, our biggest sponsor was International Paper also.
Uh-huh.
And all that's gone down the drain. So basically, on a positive note, I just received 3 donations from our normal sponsors. But it's hard to replace $6,000 on any basis.
Okay.
And all of a sudden, it's wiped out.
Okay. So you're asking for facilities and assistance?
Continued support.
People assistance. I don't want to go too far into the next administration. Ms. Olive, I don't know if you would feel comfortable in speaking to that or what.
I prefer meeting with Mr. Robinson.
Okay, that'll be fine.
Okay.
All right. Mr. Mayor.
Mr. Hamlin.
I asked Mr. Robinson about the program for Ms. Zionist Grant, and he informed me that his monies are short due to IP. Participation. And I asked him to come and address the city council as well as address the community. Let me give you a little briefing on that camp. It's named after Ms. Inez Grant. Ms. Inez Grant was a lady. She's an elementary school teacher, and she did a lot, she spent a lot of time with young people. I can recall when I was below in elementary school or junior high school, Ms. Grant was the summer recreation for us, for people in my community. The city did not provide summer programs. She used to use Mr. General Griffin truck. Mr. General Griffin, older people know him, young people don't know him, but Mr. General Griffin had the house down there on Martin Luther King. Had cattle in the back there and sold milk and stuff. But she used to put us in that truck and carry us all over Morehouse Parish. And there was a man named Mr. J.C. Smith. J.C. was the one that worked with us, actually coached us. And Ms. Grant did all the advertising, publicity, and riding. So I asked him to come. Larry, Kenny, and Calvin,
nah.
Yes, and yeah. Some more out of that group, got together and put this program together. I want to remind you that there have been other athletes from Morehouse Parish that did well, but when they was doing well, they contributed. I don't recall them contributing anything to the community from which they came. Now, my point is that those guys, along with IP, started something from our community to help us. And I'm asking that the community participate and provide some funding for them. Particularly our churches. Now, Larry, we had a meeting at our church Monday night, and I brought it up. And St. Mary is committed for $500. And we want other churches to come forth and contribute something to this program. I don't care what it is, $15, $20, whatever it is. Every little bit is going to help. And there are a lot of kids, and I'm assuming they're coming from somebody's church. And if they're not, well, maybe the ones in your church, get them to come and send a donation with them. So my plea is for the community and City of Bastrop and the surrounding area, let's come up, contribute something to this program, and let's keep it alive. Larry, Kenny, Nat, and by the way, Mayor, at one time we had one of our park and recreation employees to work with them during the hours of work hours, and that was a mean of contributing as well. So something might be worked out in that area if you get with the mayor and y'all get okay on it. Mr. Director, Park and Recreation.
Okay. One of the other thing, and Mr. Robinson hasn't mentioned this, but your organization, Pelican State Youth Movement, is 501c3 certified, right? And it's federal nonprofit, and contributions are tax deductible for individuals who would choose to contribute as well. Again, I've deferred to Ms. Olive because that would be under the administration, and she and Mr. Robinson will be talking about the city's participation in it. It's definitely a worthwhile activity. Are you still going to be using some school facilities as well? Is the school board cooperating with you this year?
They have been absolutely great.
Yes. Last year, I think you used the junior high school campus.
High school campus.
Yes. One year, you used your junior high, yes. And then you have the closing activity in Dawson Park Gym. This is not a racially exclusive program. It's cross racial, cross gender, boys, girls. They get T-shirts, shorts, and they get training. You get some pro athletes who come in and participate with you as well, I believe. If it sounds like a commercial, it is a commercial I'm advertising for.
Tell them, Larry, you do golf too. Tell them what you do, man.
Well, I'd like to comment. We were the first one to use the new track at the new high school also. So I guess that shows some respect for what we're doing.
Very good then. Well, we appreciate it. Larry Robinson, Kenny, Kevin Nat, Kenny, Alan Tansey, Jamie Mayo were all a part of that championship team back in 1975. That's a long time ago, isn't it? People don't even remember that. I don't know why we still talk about it.
Do you remember that?
She was at Delta Union.
She remembers.
It was Delta then? Okay. But anyway, we appreciate what you do, and hopefully the community as well as the City of Bastrop will continue to support you. Thank you for what you do.
Now, tell them how to get in touch with you, man. Hmm? Tell them how to get in touch with you. You and someone too.
I brought brochures about our history, so anybody that wants to know about us is right here.
Tell me the ones on the screen.
Mm-hmm. And we also have our own website. All the information is right here on the brochure.
Since you're live right now, and this is going to be constantly put on the internet, why don't you read that website out?
It's PelicanStateYouthMovement.org.
Okay.
PelicanStateYouth.org.
Would you leave some brochures at City Hall?
Yeah, I should.
And are you in the book? You in the directory?
Yes.
Under Larry Robertson?
Yes.
R-O-B-E-R-T-S-O-N.
Mm-hmm.
See, I remember that from school.
Oh, I-N-S-O-N.
R-O-B-E-R-I-N-S-O-N. I can't spell.
Mr. Robinson.
Robinson.
Can I make a quick comment? Well, turn around and hand one to the young lady in the pink. She's from the newspaper. Maybe you'll get some.
A couple of write-ups for her.
Oh, okay, good.
Mr. Lenore?
I'd just like to say that I will be contacting my church. I feel that you will get some contribution from it. But I'd like to say that in my campaign for cleanup, I called Larry one time. You know, it's difficult to get people out, and he immediately stepped forward in his youth. He was part of the group that helped us clean up in District D, and I just want to comment about that. And we were very excited about it. He didn't hesitate in saying that he would be there. So they do a lot of community projects also.
Very good. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you.
All right. Good luck. Any other citizen would like to make a comment to this mayor and board of all the persons? Okay, Ms.
There's one in the back, Mayor Holmgren.
Okay, come forward, please. If you'll come forward and give us your name and address and introduce yourself.
Mayor Hawken and the board there. Charles Van.
Okay.
I think many of you know me. It's concerning downtown, historic district, business that I myself leased in one of the buildings, and there's some concern about certain merchandise or how they advertise. And particularly myself, I have the traveling electronic motion sign. I have been told that it does not fit that criteria. And I admit I might be in violation of that, and that ordinance as to what it says and how it's supposed to be. And there's some concern, not only for me, but others that I could mention. But speaking of myself, I'm concerned about how it's written up. It seems like it puts a control of how you advertise. It seems like it keeps you from advertising the way you would like to. They got things written in there in a way that it doesn't fit today in the crisis we live in. It doesn't help, to me, it doesn't help promote business. It looks like it depresses. And this coming from a lot of merchants in downtown. Frustrated and rightfully confused. I think I talked to you a little bit about it. Mm-hmm. We're not informed on how it was written up. Only when we begin to advertise in a certain way that they don't like. Signs or maybe logos in the windows, they don't like that. So we are asking that maybe they look at it and see what can be done to help us to stay downtown. It appears to me the way it's written up is running us out.
Okay.
I mean, point blank. They talking about restoring the historicness of Bedford, but in 1963 and 70, Walmart wasn't here. So you had a lot of merchant downtown. Now Walmart's here and all the other superstores, everybody going out there. So there's no way that you can attract business downtown unless you got a demand for something. And so they trying to depress that the way that it's written up and what they're asking us to do.
Excuse me. The historic committee is scheduled to meet again when?
They meet again next month. I believe it's the third week, the third Thursday.
Okay, the historic downtown historic committee meeting will meet the third Thursday of next month. How are their meetings advertised?
They're advertised in the paper, the same as the council meeting.
Okay, through the official journal. And I've talked to staff about sending out invitations and putting packages together at the result of our meeting. Jessica Scarborough handles the clerical work for that. And what we're doing, if we haven't done it already, we're putting packages together, or have we done it yet? So what we're doing is we're sending packages with all the rules, regulations, and trying to find a better way of communicating when meetings will be held so that there can be better participation by the merchants and be involved as to when the rules and regulations are made and be able to, because I don't think you've ever met with them, have you?
Yeah, we have met with them.
Okay.
But here's my thing, too. We're not trying to,
excuse me.
I feel like they can restore it as much as they can to historic district without destroying business.
Uh-huh.
And to us, that seems like it appears to be leaning towards that way because they're restricting us as well how we can advertise, you know?
Okay.
So, and so that right there helped me to see that it's not, maybe they need to look at changing certain things to fit the merchant that's coming down. And it's not that many downtown.
That's true. That's true. So you feel that the restrictions are so prohibitive that it's making people, because they can't advertise in a way to attract. You got to have, what do you got? You got to have something to attract folks. Is that what you're saying?
Yes. Yeah. Take the instance, that's building right in front of Pippin Eater Bite. That's where I'm at.
Uh-huh.
It don't sit facing the street. It sits angle the street.
Uh-huh.
So I have to give a way of advertising so the traffic can see what I'm offering the community.
I see.
And if it's nowhere, no signs there, no can get anyone attention,
they're going to pass
you
by.
Know I'm down there.
I see. Okay.
So it's, again, it's the economy and the way it is. We have to look at the way we okay. maybe want to do things.
Let me commit in my last 18 days here to be sure that we get information out to the merchants. Jessica's working on that, and hopefully there will be better communication. Mr. Hamlin, you had a comment?
Mr. Mayor, when we adopted that policy, I argued about that, and I argued about that. I was the only person complaining about that policy.
Coming back to haunt us, huh?
That's right.
Okay. Let us try to get better communication then.
I appreciate it.
Thank you for coming, sir. Okay. Any other citizen would like to comment to this man, board of all the persons? Ms. Robinson, I think you asked for a commenting period.
Yes. Thank you, Mayor. I would like to take this time to thank all the citizens in District A for giving me the privilege of representing them for the last 8 years. I thank this Board of Aldermen and Mayor Hawkins for the progress and services that we were able to provide the city's citizens of Bastrop. We did not always agree on how to solve some problems, but we were usually ladies and gentlemen in our disagreement and resolved those differences to do what we thought best for Bastrop. Soon, Mr. Marvin Moore will be in this spot, and I believe he'll do an excellent job. Just give him a chance to get his feet wet, as all the other men that were elected. The best way for the incoming council to learn is to communicate with the people in your district, and they shouldn't hesitate to call you and let you know what is on their mind. If concerns are discussed with your representative, then they in turn will be able to make a more informed decision. I would like to thank Chief Eric Montgomery and all the firemen and the entire city of Bastrop for the job that they do. All the city employees and all the departments, the police department, from ex-police chief Alan Freeman, interim chief Jesse Walker, and the new chief, Downey Black, and all the policemen and women for all the help and the excellent job that the whole department achieves. I dare say that they don't hear those words too often of thank you. And also a big thank you to all the departments upstairs that the average public may not have interaction with a lot, but they also do a super job. A very special thank you to the ladies in the front office, Monica, Jessica, Patrice, Amanda, and Miss Sandra. They are one of the main ingredients of how to take care of business and always had the answer to all my questions. Thanks, ladies, for a wonderful job. A special thanks also to Mr. Willie McKee. There are not enough words to express his enthusiasm and help with everything that was asked of him, and he always came through. I won't be on the council anymore, but number two will still be asking and begging along with number one for help, and Mr. Willie knows who one and two are and what that's about. Mayor Hawkins, we may not always agree, but I think we worked well together, and I wish you success and prosperity in whatever lies ahead for you and your family. I would be glad to share my solution for husbands that retire with your wife, and it's called a TMTT fund, and I'll explain that later. It's called Too Much Time Together, sir. Last but certainly not least, is Mr. Cedric Hatfield. Thanks for keeping the building clean and always a refreshing smile on your face and a wonderful friendly hello whenever I entered the building and he was here. Now, on June the 31st, I will hand the baton to Mr. Marvin Moore. I challenge you to work hard for the city and the people of District A, and you should do very well. I am always available to help if and when you need me. Thank you for the rest of the aldermen. We not have had our moments, especially Mr. Hamlin.
Ms. Roberts, I'm waiting to see if you're going to include all of us in that. We appreciate that. You did.
I left the best for the last.
Yeah, you did a good job that time.
Great job.
It's been a pleasure serving with you all, and good luck to you, Miss Betty Alfred Olive, in your new adventure. And if you ever need me, you know where to find me. I hope I've not left anybody out, because I certainly didn't mean to. Thank you, District A, and all the city of Bastrop.
Thank you, Ms. Robinson.
Mayor Hawkins.
Mr. Gordon.
I, like Ms. Robinson, appreciate the opportunity to serve. I'd say dittos there, Ms. Robinson. I think she may have left out one or two folks. Mr. Lawrence and his staff always keep us in line and keep us in order. Make sure we're on the right legal pages. Mr. Bentley, who enforces the laws that we establish and put together and conform here. I think we also need to commend them, the new court system or the new court managers that are in place, that are elected. I think are doing an outstanding job and handling their end of the legislative system. I too, like Ms. Robinson, want to thank everyone that has helped me during my 4-year tenure here. I've learned a lot, and learned some things that you don't learn in school, and just some of those things you go through the school of hard knocks to learn. I appreciate my fellow council members, and Ms. Olive, I commend you on your campaign, and also look forward to the things that the city of Bastrop has to offer in the future. Mayor Hawkins, appreciate the opportunity to serve with you. Mayor Hawkins took me under his wing, so to speak, showed me around, showed me how to navigate some of the meetings and the things that we have attended, and appreciate the opportunity to serve with you, sir. To the citizens of Bastrop, I thank you.
Can I make a comment, Matt?
Mr.
I'm going to try to make it brief. I first want to thank the constituents in District D for their support. Come June the 30th, will be 20 years. It's been good to me. I left with no animosity. I feel good. I feel great. You know, God has been good to me, so I have no complaint. I just pray for this new administration that's going to be coming on, and I sincerely hope that, and I feel that you would do well. You're about like I was when I came on, a little nervous and a little scared and wondering what to do, but you'll learn over time. Make no mistake about it. I thank all of the people in the city who have worked with me so well over the years, this council, and least of all, I just want to thank my family and my wife who stuck by me. Sometimes she fought harder than I did at this, and she was the pushing force behind me. And my other family members and my churches and the other churches in my district have been very supportive. So I just want to thank those people and let them know that we love them. And I've had a great time. And I hope you have just a greater ball as I did. Thank you.
Well, I'd like to thank my wife in District E for putting up with me. They both have been good to me. I enjoy working for them. I enjoy working with the mayors and the council people. And every time some come on, you have to learn to make adjustments. So I made a bunch of adjustments. And I've talked to several employees, and I tried to keep a relationship with them where I could always come in and fellowship with them, so when I come begging for something, they wouldn't think I didn't come around until I wanted something. And I told them that. And I really appreciate the support I received from them and everyone else with the city. And Doug, I tell you again, I love to see an operation.
Thank you.
I've observed you, and I've told you that,
yes.
So I'm going to publicly tell you.
Thank
you. You handle yourself real well, and you represent the city greatly.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks, everybody.
Okay. Any other comments? This, unless there is an emergency or a special need, will be the last meeting of this mayor and board of alderpersons. And again, thank you for allowing us to serve. It's been a pleasure. And good luck to all of you in the future, and Godspeed. Is there a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Done.
That's yours.
Yeah.